Let's move on and talk about how to approach individual stocks. Nischal Maheshwari, the CEO, Institutional Equities and Advisory of Centrum Broking, joins us now. Nischal, hi, good morning and thanks for speaking with us. I wanted your take on the auto sales that have come out. Were you disappointed with this month's performance? And what would be your top bets in this space now?
Morning. Yeah, I think auto sales have been disappointing, at least especially on the CV side. We were still expecting that the CV number should be stronger than what it is. It is almost a 20% fall. Two-wheelers didn't expect any great shakes out there. So I think two-wheelers have been okay. Obviously, the silver lining is only tractors. So we continue to believe that two-wheelers still show pretty good interest out there, and again, even in case of Maruti, because most of these stocks have corrected quite a bit. So I believe in that sequence, two-wheelers, and after that Maruti is our choice of picks.
Okay, what have you made of all the happenings in Sun Pharma, Nischal? The stock was already under pressure and now further news. How are you approaching the stock?
So, Lata, I think this has been known pretty well. Basically, if you have read through these their balance sheets for years together, I think this has been pretty well known. Now, obviously, the environment is such basically that if somebody wants to put out something together for the past, market is reacting very, very negatively. So, I think it is more to do with the sentiment than anything else, because if those balance sheets have been cleared by the auditors at that point of time, I think technically they would have been right. But yes, I agree with you basically that otherwise it is not a proper way to do it, and it is issue on the corporate governance. But I think these are well-known things basically. These are from the past balance sheets.
Good morning, Nischal. What about a stock like Yes Bank? How to approach it from last week's 150 low now to 170?
Morning, Anuj. I think the way to look at Yes Bank basically is that you have to keep the bank separate from the promoters. I think it is becoming quite clear that Mr. Rana Kapoor is a promoter only and maybe playing a part on the board, but he's not the management anymore, or will be not the management beyond the beyond January. So I think we have to start looking, saying that Yes Bank as a bank, does it get impacted with whatever is happening? Then one should be worried about it. But I believe at around 150 the other day or 170 now, if you assume safely that 160 rupees is the book most of the people or analysts have for FY20 for Yes Bank, it is available at around 1.1 something like that. I think this is a good stock to keep on buying at every drop.
Okay, so good stock to buy at every fall, perhaps, Yes Bank. What about the aviation stocks, Nischal? Finally, there is some relief as far as ATF prices are concerned. Big fall in this month. Would you touch any of the aviation names?
Though we don't cover it, but Indigo is the one stock basically I would look at, given that the efficiency and the dominant market share they have. I think Indigo is only the stock basically I would be looking at.
Navi, Nischal, would you look at this bombed out sectors like power and infra? I mean, we hear now that the CERC, the Gujarat Electricity Regulator, will probably look at a new PPA that will be presented by the Gujarat DISCOM. And generally, power prices have gone up. Look at the CapEx cycle, whether you look at L&T results or whether you look at the GDP numbers. Should we look for bargains in infra?
Infra, Lata, my view has always been that you should be looking at the picks and shovels guys rather than the asset owners.
Okay.
And I don't think so as yet. I'm convinced about changing my view about that. So infra, I think the best way to play is through the EPC companies. And there, they, if you look at the order book, is 3-4 times their current sales.
Yes.
So I think there are a lot of good names out there to pick from, whether NCC or other stocks. Basically, I think best way is to play through the EPC.
Okay. What about IT names? You know, anything that you would want to buy right now, Nischal? I've seen Infosys. You know, last week, perhaps start a fresh rally. TCS has also shown signs of that. Your thoughts on the sector?
I think stocks have corrected a bit. Yes, I think the rupee, which was the main support, but my belief still continues to be there that there is a strong business case out there because after almost 6-7 years, the whole IT sector is seeing demand coming back from the US and US economy continues to do well. So I believe that there is some way to go as far as IT stocks are concerned, and they are pretty cheap, like Tech Mahindra, which I like a lot. Basically, it's only available at around 12 times FY20 numbers. So I think strong balance sheets, strong cash flows, these are good stocks to be in.
Are you buying now or will you buy only after 11th December?
So Lada, if you remember, I think a couple of weeks back I was there on your channel and I very clearly said that this is a good time to buy. Prices are in our favor basically. Yes, there will be events like December 11, what is the outcome going to happen, once again May, once again some event is going to happen. But as you go back and look into history, these events really doesn't matter much basically as far as stock markets are concerned. So there will be an impact of 2-3 days and thereafter everybody will forget about the last results.
Okay.
So I think if it stocks come to your level, I think one should be looking to buy that.
Okay, that is some sane advice. Nischal Maheshwari, always a pleasure speaking with you. Thanks so much for joining us and taking us through your views.
Thanks.
So those are some views coming in on the auto space, the banking space. In fact, all the stocks that are making the news. We'll take a short break. On the other side, we'll be back with the pre-opening rates. Stay with us.